brilliant FIFA players. And this side of the match, none more so than the game we're about to witness, I'm buzzing as well, Smiths.
Yeah, I'm buzzing, you're buzzing, and I'm pleased to say that we are almost ready to go. Yes, we are. Burnley against Aston Villa, our second quarter-final on day four of the EPL Invitational. Let's hand you back to our casters, Brandon Smith and Richard Buckley.
Thank you very much, Adam and Joan. Yeah, we're underway for our second quarter-final of the day, day number four of the EPL Invitational. Whoever wins this will book a semi-final date up against Leicester City and James Maddison, Richard. And I think everyone that's been watching this tournament throughout will be praying that we get a quarterfinal like we just had.
Oh, absolutely, Brandon. I'm very intrigued because both of these two players, not really involved with the mental sort of warfare. Will James Maddison be able to break either of these two down? Will he be able to get into their head? Because the two previous opponents that he's had, both in Southampton and Bournemouth, he's probably edged that battle. So that's another captivating area of the semi-finals coming up. But we need to find who'll be meeting James Maddison in that semi-final. Will it be Villa or will it be Burnley?
We mentioned him a number of times, Richard. The Great Wall of Me is still there at the back and involved in defending once again. That could have been a chance for Aston Villa. Still is going to be in possession for Aston Villa now. Build-up play, John McGinn, who scored a hat-trick, believe it or not. In the last game out, we saw against Jose Enrique. Keinan Davis actually got on the score sheet himself in that game. Remember, we are playing, as we said, 85-rated mode, so whether you're a 64-rated item on FIFA Ultimate Team or on usual kickoff mode, in this mode, everyone is 85-rated. So you can really start to create some of those incredible stories like we saw with Michael Obafemi when he used his own player in the game. We saw James Maddison score a golden goal winner just half an hour ago.
An early shake of the head there from Charlie Taylor.
Me again.
He's under pressure.
There he is!
Come on.
From Keinan Davis. Picking up where he left off against Jose Enrique. Keinan, have you been playing much FIFA in between your games?
Nah, I've been taking a break.
What's it like playing with yourself as well in FIFA? Because technically this is the best version of yourself that you've ever used.
Yeah, it's much different.
Charlie Taylor, quite an unrecognisable position, Brandon. Trailing in a game.
When you look at his results, Richard, he's taken out some huge names in this tournament. Beating Arsenal in round one, which he had to play to get into the round of six. I'm not too sure what's happening at the back there. Get rid of it. Keeper, get back in your goal as well. And then he went and beat Manchester City 4-3. So he had a 2-1 win and a 4-3 win. We're not seeing anything different in terms of Charlie Taylor conceding goals. He does concede goals and he hasn't had massive scorelines. It's just a case of he wins by a goal or so. So I wouldn't write him off just as of yet. Here comes Trezeguet now. Chance for Villa to get a second. It's across the box. And Jack Grealish has just made this 2-0.
And this is the first time in the EPL Invitational that Charlie Taylor has been trailing. See a smile on his face. Has to show something different here in the first 20 minutes. It just looks all a bit too rudimental potentially for Villa. And Keinan Davis. I said in his first game against Jose Enrique, Keinan Davis, up to what we'd seen, Brandon, the most well-rounded FIFA player in terms of knowing the game, knowing the basics, fundamental FIFA that we have seen.
Well, and said, yeah, you know, he's a player we should be watching out for in this tournament. Definitely a player that could even go the full way. And whoever wins this goes into the semi-final, chance for another one. Wow, it could have been if he was just on the side there with his own player. Keinan Davies leading by 2-0. 24 minutes gone in this game. And Villa back with possession. Charlie Taylor really struggling at the moment.
Struggling to build up as he did in his previous games as well. The possession that he was holding, building through the thirds. That's sort of been eradicated in his first 25 minutes. It's been Keinan Davies just bossing the game.
Oh, what a goal.
This could be three. This could be three. It will be.
What a goal.
Keinan Davies stealing the words out of my mouth. What a goal.
Oh.
Incredible stuff. Jack Grealish the first half brace. Charlie Taylor. Charlie, what's gone wrong? He's been able to really get going in this game, and it's the press that Villa are showing.
It's the exact same press that he showed against Liverpool when he beat him 6-1. That was Jose Enrique. 3-0 up inside 30 minutes. Keinan Davis. I'm going to go out and say it. He's the man to beat.
Really struggling with that pass from defence to midfield at the moment. That's where a lot of possession has been lost. Chance to break now for Burnley. Remember, last time out, they made a semi-final. Dwight McNeil had a fantastic running in the first ever ePremier Invitational. This time around, they are back in a quarter-final, but unfortunately they're 3 goals down. The third of this game already played. Massive switch of play. And this too, lovely Ronaldo chop around the corner. Chance for another one for Villa. Cuts back inside. It's John McGinn scoring goals.
And Keinan Davis, McGinn again.
4-0 up. Does John normally score this many goals in FIFA? I swear he normally doesn't.
Keinan Davis. What's he like playing with John McGinn in real life, Keinan?
Oh, he's a great player. Very good left foot as well.
Are you happy this time that you've been able to kind of take the role? Because John didn't have really a tournament to remember last time out, did he?
Yeah, exactly. He was the wrong man for the job.
I know you spoke a lot about him, Richard, but have they found the right man for the job now in Keinan Davis? 4-0 in a quarter final.
I mean, just look at the way he's playing. Keeping the ball in the midfield, building up in possession. McGinn driving towards him. That would have been an unbelievable goal, keeping possession and then releasing that thunder bolt from John McGinn's left boot. But he just looks very well-rounded in all of the areas of the pitch. Defence, he knows that how to jockey. He knows how to sort of hold players up. Midfield, not rushing, keeping the ball, moving left to right. In the attacking third, drag backs. He's looking for the cutback every time. The most effective way of scoring in FIFA. Lovely play from Jack Grealish, looking for that finesse shot. But it just looks like the complete package.
You also cast your mind back as well, Richard, to that round of 16 game where Aston Villa did knock out Liverpool. Jose Enrique representing Liverpool in that game. What did he do, Richard? He scored all his goals in the first half, really. He took the lead early on, built his goals into it in the second half. I think he was just trying to score with himself, of all honesty. And that will do us for half-time. I'll tell you what, Aston Villa, we might as well put them in the semi-finals right now.
Dominant. There we go. It is 4-0 at the halfway mark. Commentator Brandon Smith saying we might as well put them in the semi-final now. It's been that one-sided. Keinan, you must be delighted with that first half performance.
Yeah, some great first half. Could not say anything more.
And of course, you scored with yourself again. You're getting a lot of joy with your own in-game player.
Yeah, I am. He's been playing well.
Let's speak to Charlie. Charlie, you've had a good run. Obviously, the game's still going on. 4-0 down, though. A lot to do in this second half. What went wrong in that first half, mate?
Just about everything. I don't even want to look at them start. Yeah, just shocking from the first minute. It's getting a bit embarrassing now. I just probably got to try and keep it below 5.
I was going to ask you that. You're probably trying to keep it below 5. It's probably preempted the next question. We saw a little bit of a comeback in our first game. Are we about to witness one of the greatest comebacks of the tournament? Can you pull this around?
Probably got to get a shot on target first, to be honest.
There we go. Very modest from Charlie Taylor. I've probably got to get a shot on target in order to get back into the game. It is 4-0. Second half's underway. Let's head back to our casters, Brandon and Rich.
Yeah, well, I think he hit the nail on the head there, Rich. He needs to get a few more shots on target if he wants to get himself back into this game. Into the second half now. Aston Villa 4-0 up in this quarterfinal.
I saw a glimpse of the stats at halftime. I think it were 10 shots, 7 on target for Keinan Davis, for Burnley. Don't know if Charlie registered a shot. Goodmanson playing through Chris Wood. This could be the start of the comeback. Charlie gets a goal. 4-1.
Tell you what, Richard, it was a goal that Burnley needed. Who was it? You hyped him up before the game. Chris Woody's been involved in literally everything for the Clarets in the EPL Invitational. Perfect way to start this second half.
I also saw in that bottom right corner, team press implemented on by Charlie Taylor. Players going to be flooding forward now in the Claret. McNeil wins it back. Another chance potentially here. Chris Wood going through. Overhit. Pepe Reina comes out and collects.
Yeah, slightly heavy on that pass. If that did go through, I'll tell you what, Richard, what a game we'd have on our hands. Best thing that Keinan Davis can do is just score a goal, put this game to bed. You'll be back in front by 4-0. Of course, the score would be 5-1. Here's that chance. Is that the goal? Save needed by Nick Pope. Happy target with that one into the box, headed away by Lowton.
Chance here, potentially. Charlie Taylor himself.
He's making that run still on the left bottom corner of your screen, but Burnley will come forward. You look for that whip across. Maybe the wrong option. Went for the pass around the corner instead.
Yeah, he didn't really have many options, to be honest. Goodmanson out wide there. He could have cut back, but it was getting a little bit crowded inside the box. He went for that pass across. Reina doing very well just to smother it. But a much better second half performance here from Charlie Taylor.
He's been able to create a lot more, which is what he needs after conceding 4 goals. Once again, we're seeing the same sort of situation here against Liverpool when Aston Villa played them earlier on in the tournament in the round of 16. We saw Keinan Davis score all his goals really in the first half and show that dominance. Second half here, Chaito has had a few chances. This would be game over if it goes in. So and honestly, I think that's done now, Richard, in my opinion. 25 minutes left in it at the back post. A Villa player was there, and a Villa player will get on the score sheet again. Trezeguet with the goal. I think it will be a semi-final of Leicester against Aston Villa.
Yeah, coming in the back post, Trezeguet always going to be favourite there. Beautiful cross from Keinan Davies. He almost takes his foot off the gas a little bit. He knows that the game, in his own head, he's pretty much done. It's wrapped up at half-time, and gives his opponent a little bit of false hope, but Charlie Taylor has had an incredible run in this tournament, Brandon. Kim is pretty much an unknown quantity. We didn't really know what to expect from his FIFA ability, but been very impressed what he has produced.
I mean, if you look at the results he's had as well, Rich, he has to come through the round one, which is never going to be easy. Trezeguet looking to make it 6 if he can get round the corner. Ball to the back post. And who else is going to score than himself? Set himself up for a hat-trick. That's Keinan Davis.
Oh, he's getting embarrassing now.
Charlie, just a quick one. How good is Keinan Davis?
Yeah, unbelievable.
Cheers.
You can't get anywhere near him.
Really impressive. Every single attack, he looks like he is going to score. Which for some players, isn't always the case. As we said, semi-final will be in writing. That will be taking place tomorrow. And that will see Leicester's James Maddison, who won in golden goal against Southampton, up against Aston Villa's Keinan Davis.
Yeah, Maddison, Gravis. Hands cut out for him. It's going to be a very, very tough game versus Keinan Davies. Could be looking at the eventual winner here, Brandon. I'm going to put it out there. Could be looking at the winner.
I know you've always been a favourite of what Keinan has showed throughout the tournament so far. If he does win this game by 6-1, it'll be the exact same result that he got in the round of 16 against Jose Enrique of Liverpool. Unless he wants to add another one to the list. Davies was in there. Just couldn't get his foot around the ball. McGinn to Trezeguet into the final 10 minutes now. Of course, he will be saying goodbye to Burnley. They will fall slightly early in the competition after making the semi-final last time. There's another chance. There's another goal. Everything, it seems that any Aston Villa touches in that final third turned into gold. It's another goal. It's seven in total.
Low driven as well at the near post from El Ghazi, from Keinan Davis. Just when I was talking earlier about the real completionist of the sort of FIFA manual, you've got to say, having the drag backs, having the different shot types that you can do in certain areas, the driven pass, all these things Keinan Davis is showing and more, Brandon. Nobody else has shown that level of sort of expertise in the tournament.
Is that really dangerous? Scoring an incredible amount of goals. In total, 13 in the tournament. That's only from round of 16 and this quarter final. Didn't go in the round one. But we'll be adding Burnley to the list of teams that he has knocked out in this tournament. A semi-final awaits him of Leicester City and James Maddison. That is going to be a game full of goals. Burnley. Yeah. Oh, Charlie.
Charlie Taylor conceded 4 goals in his previous 2 matches. He's conceded 7 in 1 game here through the hands of Keinan Davis. He said 8. It is 8.
Off the record here.
I want 9.
You are actually matching up the score that we saw in the round 1 game between Bournemouth and Leicester. That was an 8-1 scoreline. He wants to get one more. Be the most goals scored in a game that we've seen for one single team. And there goes the full-time whistle. Congratulations, Keinan Davis. You will be in the semi-finals. Unfortunately, Charlie Taylor, head in hands. It hasn't been a quarter-final performance to remember.
So, Keinan, 6 goals in your first game, 8 goals in your second game. How many are we going to see in your next game?
Hopefully 9. Trying to progress each game.
Charlie, that was a very tough game, wasn't it? Keenan's a really good opponent.
Yeah, very good. Surely he's got to go on and win it from what I've seen today. but yeah, I'm going to be conceding 8 goals there. That's just, it was embarrassing at half-time. It's just got even worse.
So where do you think the match was won and lost? Do you think you just didn't turn up yourself, or was Keinan that good?
I just think Keinan was that good. Like, I can't compete with that. That's, that's just, the standard's far too good for me there. I'm happy just to make the quarterfinals, to be honest.
And Keinan, how enjoyable has it been playing in this tournament? What does it mean to the Villa fans?
Yeah, it's good. A bit of fun as well, and it's good for a good cause. So yeah, it's just all round good.
And obviously you're going to be facing James Maddison in the semi-finals. So how much are you looking forward to finals day?
Yeah, very excited. I saw his game earlier. He was a good player. So it should be a good game.
Now, James Madison's known for his mind games. Are you going to let him get in your mind? Are you going to be doing any mental preparation to try and stop that happening?
No, I'm just going to focus on myself, focus on the game, hopefully get a win.
There we go then. Congratulations to Keinan Davis. Commiserations to Charlie Taylor. Thank you very much to both of the players for joining us today.
Cheers.
Cheers, thank you.
Yeah, Joe, what a game that was. I think we spoke earlier, all 4 of us, myself, you, Brandon and Richard, and we're trying to work out who was the favourite there and sort of making out this.